Hi everybody, this is the Human Colony Saturday webinar special edition. It's a mini channel panel again this morning. Today is January 28th, 2017, and we are blessed to have Adey, Mariah, JD, and Justin Arnott joining us today to channel for us. So we have some really cool things in store. I know this is JD's first time channeling for a webinar like this, and he especially is into light languages and very talented with singing, so I'm really excited to see what might come through. He's just going to let it flow. Adey and Justin, we have had on here before, so welcome back to both of you. And I'm really excited. This is going to be awesome. I heard there's going to be some really cool information that's going to come through today, of course, for the highest, greatest good of all. So really quick announcement as far as what we have up and coming. Please go to humancolony.org to be able to check our calendar of events to see what we're about to do, and you can always join our YouTube watch page or our participation links by going to humancolony.org/jump. So checking our calendar, we have some cool stuff coming up. Saturday, February 4th, I believe that Jim Charles is joining us again next week for the webinar, and he has to still confirm that, but I believe so. Sunday, February 12th, we have Brooke Alissom is joining us again, and that'll be 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And Max is going to be hosting for her. And then Saturday, February 18th, we have Sean Swanson, the well-known channeler of the Ishwa of the Yahyel, and he is going to be coming in for a webinar at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time with both Max and Jim there. So that's going to be very cool that we're having him on. Also, we have weekly book meetings every Friday. We are working on a Human Colony book where we are transcribing channelings, new channelings that are coming in through Jim and other people, and also old channelings as well. If you would like to help us transcribe videos, information, especially in different languages, helps a lot too. We have a project for that as well. Please let us know. You can email max@humancolony.org in order to get involved, and we're going to be publishing this stuff, and it's going to be out there, and it's going to be awesome. So please let us know if you want to be a part of that. Also, you can go to humancolony.org/donate if you would be willing to give us any money whatsoever for us to continue having a website online and doing the other stuff that we do in order for us to continue functioning as a non-for-profit, completely volunteer-based, totally awesome group of channelers and people on spiritual paths together on Earth. All right, I think that I covered everything. I'm not sure if I have really any other announcements, except for I kind of got to throw this in here because Justin is on the channel panel today, and since the last webinar he did earlier this month, him and I are working together, and we are building a website. You can find our YouTube channel, UnityX/Change on YouTube. We are releasing channelings. He's doing private sessions. He's doing healing, and I'll talk about more of that stuff later. Spiritual self-protection and a lot of other really awesome stuff. So I'm super excited that I get to be a part of this, and everybody is doing their own awesome things. So please continue supporting other light workers because we're all on the same mission. So with that said, are there any announcements or anything that I have missed? Anything that anyone would like to bring up?
I actually do have one.
Okay.
Just one small announcement. Joe and I are going to continue to do our discussions on my channel. There may be one tomorrow. I know he's really busy at the moment, so there may be one tomorrow. If not, in the future, we will continue the talks or the discussions. Okay, that's all I have. I don't know if anybody else has anything.
Awesome. Okay, thank you, Adey. You can find that on Adey's YouTube channel, Adey Mariah, correct? That's where it'll be.
I think I muted myself. And I believe it's in the description bar below too.
Yes, it is. Yep, all the links are down in the description, so please check them out. We have awesome stuff in the works. Super stoked. So Great. With that said, as the channelings happen today, we might take some questions depending. They might do messages first and we will kind of see. We'll go with the flow. If you have a question, you can post it in the YouTube Live or in our other chat boxes we have, you know, here on the side or anything. I'll be watching for mobile users. Lots to keep track of. So let's get started, I suppose. If there's no other announcements, I guess, do we have any light language blessings that anyone would like to do before we have Adey go right ahead? I believe I will get started with a light language blessing really quickly, and then if anyone would like to go after me, please go for it. So, Nihisio so toko shin ta hai an to oko to oro no to toko o ne shi an da hata aya to toko o se enti shi an hai e siaka ya nahara ta osa haya mihia so toko shin ti hikia ya to oto toko shon to oho aya na auto toko hotea. Namaste.
I'll go on the next one. Okay. All right. No, ya haya la kaya na ya. Oyo hoya na ya manaya. Yo wo hoya haya la kaya na ya. Yo wo yo hoya na wo ko yo shono yo na na ya. Ya manaya kaya na yo ko yo tono yo na na ya. Blessings.
Thank you, Pete. Awesome. I didn't mean to only say light language blessings, by the way. We, of course, would take any blessings in the universe in any language, so I wanted to make that clarification. Michelle wants to do one next. Thank you, Michelle.
I caught that one. Open the channels and let the energy flow. Positivity for all.
Beautiful. Awesome. Well, thank you guys for helping raise the vibes this morning. We appreciate it. And with that said, I think we can get started with you, Adey, really quickly, because I feel like I want to introduce everybody properly here. You have been a channeler for a while now, and you're also a healer, which you have awakened to recently, your awesome healing capabilities. And so you are continuing on your path in order to bring the highest, greatest divine messages for those who need to hear it. And I've got to say that I've had some pretty amazing conversations and experiences with Adey. Actually, everybody here has channeled for me, and it's been awesome, all three of you. So this is super exciting. So Adey, please go right ahead with what you were going to bring for us today.
Thank you so much, Bree. And I do want to say, as far as the questions, if we do not get to all of your questions, I highly apologize. My email is probably in the description bar, so you can email them to me if you wish, and I will respond in a timely manner as much as I can. So with that said, I will get started. I do have, today's an interesting one. I'm channeling a human. But a human that lives in inner earth. So I connected to this person a few days ago. He's here. He's interesting looking, so I will describe him. He did not give me a name, But he said, I asked what I should call him, what their race is, and he just said humans. He said, we once walked this earth on the surface with all of the humans in the times of Lemuria, Atlantis, part of Egypt. And when the energy shifted, they had receded down under. And so this person is, he's a man, he's elderly. He reminds me of a cross between a Native American and African American. The skin is a little orange and the face is round. The hair is really, really interesting. It's very straight, but it doesn't move. It's like wiry, kind of. So let me see what he wants to start with. One moment. So he just did his greeting and he's talking about their history a little bit. So that, yeah, they did walk. He said that at that time, aliens and humans walked on this, on the surface peacefully. Of course, the energy or the, we were in fourth dimension. The shift happened for many reasons, he said. Humanity needed to go through their lessons. Oh, and he also said that they are the ones that are responsible, along with other aliens, for the grid that is over our planet. And this is the grid that sets our vibration. And so when that lowered, a lot of the aliens left, those that did not need to be taken the lesson with us. And his race, as well as other humans, receded to the inner earth. And they are still responsible for the grid, even underground. There's a lot he wants to cover, so I need to tell him to take it easy a little bit. One moment. They do speak a language, but they also communicate in telepathy, and that's mainly what they use. He wants to get into about the disturbance that has been going on inner Earth. Now, his group, as well as others that are underground, they are called the Watchers or the guardians of this planet. They do add to the vibration of the planet, just like we do. But he's saying some of them have been manipulated by the cabal. And so they have shifted their focus from service to others to service to self. And so this is what's causing a lot of the disturbance underground. A lot of the earthquakes that have been felt all across the planet are due to a lot of the battles that are going on. But now that our collective is starting to wake up and we're raising our vibration, the grip that the cabal has on, not only on our vibration, but underground has starting to loosen a little bit. Now, Gaia not only gets her energy from us, but she gets it from the planets in the solar system, the sun, and other planets. She has a twin flame as well out there. She's getting all of the energy from them to support Gaia and us into moving up to the fourth and fifth dimension. So I guess he just came to do a little update. Now this may be new to some of you, it's new to me, and to some of you it may be information that you've heard before. I'm trying to see if he has anything else to say. Okay, so I don't think that he has anything else he wants to add. If there are any questions regarding this, I did not get a name. He did not. One moment, let me see. Markoul is the name that he wants to go by.
And okay.
That's all I have from him. He brought his whole clan with him, too. It's interesting.
Oh, wow. Is there an approximation of, I mean, so they're humans, do they function and have the similar lifespans? And I mean, is it very similar to us in that regard? Oh, one second. How strange. There's a glitch and it said that I muted you a day and I didn't. So love when this happens.
I'm trying. Okay, I think I'm unmuted. That's okay.
Good.
I did hear your question. I don't know how long ago I was muted. Did you guys get the name?
Yeah. No, I'm just after my question.
I didn't realize that.
You're good.
Yeah, their lifespan is a little bit longer than ours, actually. This has to do with energy intake. He's saying their diet, they eat half as much as we do. They get provided with nutrition through energy. And it's interesting. He's showing me like their underground city. It's very similar to ours. They have a sky, they have a sun. Their sun is different than ours, of course. He said that some of them do come to the surface from time to time because they, you know, they miss it. They want to connect to the stars and the sun. So they do make their way up, but they try to go unnoticed. And they're starting to make themselves more known to humans because he's saying now is the time that we work together to achieve the ascension. And he also said, now that the grid is lifting a little bit, it's allowing for energy to come through. By energy, he means all the aliens that left before have returned to help us. They've returned to help us. But the thing is, they can only help us as much as they can. We have to do some of the work as well. We have to work on ourselves. This isn't anything I haven't heard before, but that's the message he has.
Okay, very interesting. I actually do have some questions because I remember back when a few weeks ago it was, you had been in contact with the Golden Triangle head beings. So I don't know if I'm allowed to kind of bring this up and talk about this. I know they're a little bit, they kind of stay quiet, but you had said that they were the Watchers of Gaia and part of the Inner Earth, and they were a part of the Spearhead Alliance. So are these humans also a part of this?
They are a part of an Inner Earth Alliance, but they're not in the same group. There are many different alliances under the Earth, over the Earth, that are considered the Watchers of the Earth.
Aha, so different kinds of Watchers.
This is a different Inner Earth Alliance. They are very close to us, not only genetically, but just they've been around us a lot longer. And also he's mentioning humans have been around a lot longer than what our science has told us. And also the Earth has been around a lot longer than what science has told us. But science is starting to catch up to that right now.
How interesting. Sam was asking if they're Telosian.
Oh, you know what? I've heard that before. Let me ask. No, but they're closely related. This is a different group. He truly identifies himself as a human.
Okay. Okay. So,
you.
Sounds like it. That's very interesting. I mean, we find out about these inner earth civilizations and we're like, oh, they must all be, you know, different. And it turns out, I mean, you had even been talking about the other dimensions of earth that you have been to, that you've experienced underground. So those dimensions you were talking about, would you consider them to be inner earth?
Well, I didn't go to inner earth that time that you're talking about. The time that I was telling you I went to another dimension, it was still here on the surface, but it's like my vibration was raised. And when I walked through the portal, I was able to see the being that was waiting for me. The being that I was connecting with, the golden triangle head being, was a higher dimensional being. And so in order for me to see this being, I had to not only raise my vibration, but meet him at his level, at a higher dimension. So it's still like here, the surface, but a much higher frequency, if that makes sense.
Yeah. And I've actually recently seen a rendition of a golden triangle head being. I'm trying to remember who had, it might have been Vashta Narada. Sorry for putting her on the spotlight if it wasn't her, but I'm almost positive it was her. She has amazing galactic artwork that she makes. She has her own website. I think it's like Vashta's. Google Vashta Narada art, you know.
On Facebook, right?
Yeah, on Facebook. And she also has her own website. And I have seen a rendition recently of them. And it's funny because it looked exactly like you had described, you know.
Yeah.
Very tall, very skinny, golden, shiny triangle head.
Yeah, and they kind of like, I don't know if they're actually solid. It's they kind of like wobble or like a wave when they move. It's really interesting. I never tried to touch one, but
They're very bright. It's super interesting. And I remember when we were originally talking about them, because I mean, now we're just kind of talking a little bit about inner earth in general, you know, just from our past discussions. You know, I was kind of wanting to ask, why the Spearhead Alliance and these other inner earth beings stay down in the inner earth. And basically it seemed like it was because we as a collective on earth were not ready until, I mean, now we're starting to at least be ready to hear about it, you know, but that's what it seemed to be about, right?
It's not just that. It's also tied to vibration. They are at a much higher vibration, and we are not. And so it would be hard for them to walk amongst us with the vibration that they carry. It's not safe for them or us at the same time.
Makes sense. Just like a lot of the extraterrestrial civilizations that can only come here astrally, because if they came here physically, they would like get really sick.
That is also tied to our government as well. Government is not allowing it. So there's a lot of factors to this, but he's more concerned with the vibrational differences.
Okay, that makes sense. So we do have a few questions. Let's see, it says, Carolina is asking, how are you connected with the Naga? Are they also inner earth?
Oh, I don't know if I have any connections with them.
Oh, I think she's asking about the human that you were speaking to.
I don't know if this human isn't, okay, she's asking him if he has a connection to the Naga.
Believe so, yes.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I misunderstood. Well, one moment. Very much so. They are connected because the Naga are connected to the earth and they've had, you know, lifetimes here, close connections. They draw energy, they replenish each other's energy. He considers any being that is connected to the earth like the Nagas are, like as a relative, like how they consider us relatives. They are relatives. That's his answer.
Oh, that's interesting. Okay, thank you. Kina is asking, can they clarify about the hypothalamus gland, pituitary gland, and pineal gland? How do they use them, and do they have any advice to us for our third eye health and all that stuff?
Well, theirs isn't calcified like ours. They have a much larger hypothalamus. They communicate with each other through their third eye. I see energy leaving, a light leaving their third eye and connecting to the other. That's how they communicate mostly, aside from the spoken language. And what was the second part of her question? Any advice for us?
Yeah, advice about us with our third eye and using those three glands for our highest greatest good.
Yeah. Okay, one moment. There is a lot, but to some of you, this may be something that you've heard before. But so he's suggesting certain fruits like pineapples are great for decalcifying your pineal gland. Oranges. Definitely diet has something to do with decalcifying your pineal gland. And that helps your third eye in a great way. Meditation, meditation for not only your third eye, but for your overall chakra well-being. So that's what he has to offer as far as that for the third eye and the pineal gland.
Okay.
I hope that answers your question.
Yeah. Kina was also asking about zeolite, I believe.
I'm not sure what that is. I hope he knows.
Yes, it's for decalcification.
That's the process of calcification?
It's a product who absorbs heavy metals.
Oh, okay, yeah, the heavy metals that we're bombarded with. So there, you want to know if there are any ways you can detox your body from that? That's what he's asking.
It was only asking him if he knows about zeolite, if it was advised to take it for helping only.
Yeah, that. To detoxify. Yeah, that's what he's asking you. So yeah. It is somewhat helpful. Now, their race prefers more of the diet and the meditation aspect, but there are, you know, minerals and supplements out there that you can use, and that's one of them for sure. Boron is another one too.
Awesome! Yeah, great boron, stuff. Boron,
iodine.
Yeah. All right.
To flush your body.
Okay, thank you. All right, we have some more questions. Angie, I just want to clarify this. Angie was asking if they are orange, if they are orange human race.
They're not bright orange. They're just like a cross between, it's a darker skin tone, like an African American, but with an orange tint.
Interesting.
Cool. Like I said, you know how the Native American skin is like not very dark, but olive. Is it olive? I don't know how to best describe it. That with an orange tint to it.
Okay.
And a wide face. Like, I mean, what is that? A round face.
All right. Wow. Cool. All right.
South Africa. I don't know what you're asking, Angie.
Well, she said there's some orange people in South Africa.
Oh,
she had seen a few of them.
Yeah.
So she was kind of wondering about that. It's very cool. Okay. Some more questions. Let's see. It looks like David has a question. David, are you able to unmute? I think he gestured.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Hi David.
Yep. Hi. Good to meet you. I wanted to ask about, they said that they visit the Earth sometimes, and I wanted to invite them to where I'm living at, because there's the land has like a vortex, and I thought it might be a good place for them to visit. It would be good to meet them if possible. It's at the place where we held the last webinar.
I'm not sure where that was. Sorry, but let me relay the message. He just bowed, so I assume that means thank you. Now, I don't know if he mentioned where they're located, but his particular group is located in the South Antarctica region. That's mostly where they reside. So if they do come above the Earth and the surface, it will be in that area.
Okay.
But he sends you lots of love, and he's very thankful. Of course.
Well, if he ever wants to make it over that way, he's welcome.
Well, thank you. That was sweet. Did you have a question for him? Any other questions?
I'm not sure right now.
Okay.
If there's anything that he wants to share with me,
to
hear something, that would be good for my journey, healing as a healer, and getting the word out to help people.
Okay, he's showing me pictures right now. So he's showing me you taking leaps and get great strides, and so that's great. Continue on that. You seem to draw your energy from not only Gaia, but from the angelic realms. He said that will expand to, you'll start opening up to other beings that are there to help you with your healing. Well, they're willing to connect to you as well, so feel free to call on them.
Oh, beautiful.
As far as raising your vibration and your frequency, they can help you do that. And you can actually do grid work also. If you're not already involved with that, you can definitely help with that.
Oh, how would I learn, or who would I connect with to learn?
Them. They are one of the main ones that help with the grid over the Earth, help lift it to allow energy to come through.
That's beautiful. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Looks like Michelle, did you have a question?
I do. I was wondering if they could tell us in our understanding about what density or dimension, density level.
They are.
I was curious. And then I would follow up.
Upper fourth, middle fifth.
Okay. I'm really interested in like allowing to remember my Lumerian lifetimes, and since they were here at that time. And also I was asked to send healing to Agartha. So I guess I want to know a couple of things. Like, do I need to learn, like, is it important for me to study like grid lines or anatomy or whatever? Because I do a lot of speaking and healings, but I don't legitimately have a concrete idea in my head. And I always thought that was a good idea so that I didn't get my ego involved in it. But I don't know if that is accurate. And I want to be the best helper buddy I can. So I would like some guidance and or any information he wants to share with me about my role in being a helper.
Okay, one moment. So he's saying that a lot of you are being guided to send your healing energy to Agartha and Inner Earth to help with the disturbance that is happening right now. And as for you, you've been doing a lot of that even when you're not aware of it. In astral, you've been sending energy, not just to Agartha, but to Gaia as a whole. You're very well connected to Gaia. And a lot of you are starting to recall your Lumerian and Atlantis lifetimes, because we are returning to that energy that we once held, the one that you call the Golden Age. And so this is to help you remember your past so that you can move forward in this ascension. Now, as far as you knowing anatomy and physiology, yes. Yes, because this is going to be involved in your healing work.
Okay.
You're not only working with the earth, but you're working with humans and with individuals. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the physical ailments that manifest have to do not only with your physiology, but with energy work. Mm-hmm. So it is beneficial for you to know exactly where to direct the energy when you're sending out your healing, when you're working with humans.
Okay.
Knowing the region and the physiology.
Okay. Does, in his or their estimation, and see, I've always had this idea, or this is maybe me, just me being lazy, but I've had this idea that I'm a hollow bone, and so therefore it's not for me to decide where it goes. Like, the energy goes where it needs to go. So I have been definitely on the lazy track on that, but if he says let's do it, I'll do it.
That's not entirely wrong. It depends on what type of healing work that you're doing. You know, some healing work will be very precise and specific, you know, when you're helping someone that's in pain. Mm-hmm. And then some will be for the overall health of the chakras and the body system. And so it's, don't think of it as laziness.
Okay. Is it, I was told by someone one time, I'm not just healing chakras. She said, Michelle, you are not just healing chakras in the body. This is a soul. This is like an infinite soul. Can he explain that idea?
Yeah.
And if that is accurate with regard to the type of healing that a lot of us do.
So he's saying, yes, go ahead.
Well, I was thinking of Reiki in particular, but then again, like, I mean, all of us here, most of us have some sort of training and or not even training, just like abilities, like, I mean, and it's all different, you know, like I make tones and sometimes I speak languages and also I do Reiki and sometimes I just use my imagination and make stuff up.
No, imagination is good.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry, I forgot your original.
So I was told that this healing isn't just about making the pain go away.
Yeah,
it's about the whole beyond.
Yes, because
the soul healing.
Yeah, I remember now. Sorry. So yeah, your chakras carry a lot of your lifetimes with you. That is your information. That is a reminder of what you're here to do, what you're here to clear. So when you're healing each chakra system, you're healing a part of the soul that needs to be released. You know, the karma, the pain, the blockage. And so think of it that way. That's okay. What that means.
Okay, that's really good. Yeah, it's super fun too.
Indeed.
Oh, much love, blessings. Thank you.
Much love, thank you. All right, I think that's it for me, right, Bree? Or is there?
We have a few more minutes.
Oh, okay.
So we can let you keep going a little bit. We did have some more questions. It looks like, let's see. Sorry, where'd I missed it here. Akina was asking if, she said, I was a being in Agartha. Are they able to say a few words about that, if it's relevant?
Yeah, of course. One moment. You are many beings, so one moment while I look at what he's showing me. A fairy? A giant? I don't know what this being I'm looking at is, but it's very hairy. An elf? And you've even had past lives with them, as one of them. We've all had many, many lifetimes in the inner earth, Agartha. So yeah, I hope that answers your question.
That's very interesting. Okay, thank you. Awesome. I'm going to read one of Xiao's questions that she had sent to you. She said, why do humans always find something to be worshipped, say religion, celebrities, or an ideology? Is this worship thought built in our genetics by the negative beings, or is it a part of the evolutionary process which species must go through?
Wow, that's an excellent question. Okay. Well, he's saying that it wasn't always like that. Back in the golden age, we all knew ourselves. We knew who we were. We knew our abilities. We were connected to source a little bit more. And so we didn't feel the need to worship or follow anyone. Now, once we fell asleep and the energy shifted, it's almost like we lost our connection to the spirit realm and ourselves. And so, yes, we went into that want and need to be led because we had no idea. What was the other part of her question?
She essentially was asking if it's built into our genetics or if it's a part of the evolutionary process.
It's not part of our genetics, but it is part of the evolutionary process. And now we are starting to find our way again, and we are starting to wake up to a lot of the control that's been going on. So, yeah.
We're evolving. So I guess I just would like to relate this with an example that I had heard that really blew my mind, in terms of, you know, saying that it's a part of evolutionary process that some species go through. Can't say all species because, you know, everybody has
a different journey.
Yeah, their own gig, their own game to play. But but I had heard of the Cinderella Collective. Now, I can't confirm any of this, but I have a friend who is connected to the Cinderella Collective, as they call themselves, and it completely fascinated me. She channeled them for me, and it turns out that they are distantly related, I believe, to the Shekinah, and which is Bashar's race, so a little more on like the gray human hybrid side, I think. And what's so fascinating is, or maybe they're more gray, maybe there isn't a human component, I'm not entirely sure, I'm sorry, but they went through a very similar awakening, I guess, that we did, where they were lied to, deceived, put down, you know, told the wrong information, told the wrong history, didn't know how powerful they are, didn't know that magic is real, that miracles are able to happen, that things are amazing. And slowly over time, as they started to awaken and reintroduced magic back into their lives, as we are doing with us intentionally starting to create our own realities, understanding this amazing spiritual information, they ascended. They woke up and they ascended. And it was so interesting for me to hear this because it sounded like a very similar situation to us. So yeah. I just wanted to add that in there to her question.
That's true. There are other civilizations and other planets that are going to a similar ascension process. Very true.
Yes, absolutely fascinating. You know, we're not the only ones, although we picked a pretty interesting ride, that's for sure. So, wonderful. Well, Adey, I wish we could keep going, but I believe we should move forward onto our next channeler we have. So I just really wanted to thank you for joining us again today and for bringing forth those messages, and thank Markoul, was his name?
Yeah.
Markoul?
That's the name he goes by, yep.
Markoul, yeah. Awesome. Well, appreciate him coming through and, you know, talking to us and bringing our awareness to the fact that his civilization exists, and we're looking forward to learning more about the inner Earth civilizations and all of the beings that we can contact if we so wish. So thank you so much, dear.
Thank you all. Much love and blessings.
And please check the links at the bottom. Adey's website is there, and everything else. So we definitely appreciate that. And she does private sessions. Don't forget that. They are awesome. Awesome, awesome. JD, you're up next. And JD, you've been with Human Colony since the beginning, pretty much, haven't you? It's been a while, man.
Yeah, I think it's 2 years. I'm not counting, but I think it's over 2.5 years, maybe.
Yeah, for a long time. Yeah, so we're really excited to have you here, and really excited for the beautiful frequencies you're going to pull through today. So, you know, if you are going to take any questions, of course, just let me know. But otherwise, please go right ahead.
Yeah, I just wanted to tell you all, thank you for being here. If you were here, I wouldn't be here, so... it all makes sense to me that you are my guides, all of you, everyone I know, everyone I feel is a part of me that I recognize in myself deeper, the deeper I go, and it just becomes more and more beautiful and more enlightening and more wonderful and more it's more and more making sense to all the feelings that I always had since I can remember. And I'm so blessed, and I will go into a meditation, and I posted in the post on the side here the text of this Love, Peace and Harmony song that has helped me personally, and it's a gift from a master whose name is Dr. Master Shaw, and he has linked me together with Master Paul, which I have been working with the last month, and we basically do blessings and we sing this song, and it's a mantra. And I will just say personally, the more I sing the song, the better I feel, and more makes sense to me the more I sing this mantra. And so I would just suggest you to sing along with me, and we can create a beautiful feeling for us to live in this now that we are all in. So thank you all. It's important that you take your time also. There's nothing that anyone is needing to hurry up. Everything's waiting for you. So Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, la, li. Lula, lula, li, lula. Lula, li, lula. Lula, li, lula. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace and harmony. Love, peace and harmony. And then you can make it with a smile and it feels so much better. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace and harmony. Love, peace and harmony. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So this is Johannes' mother talking right now. I am his soul mother, always with him, always loving him, always guiding him. He's aware of it, but he's still doubting it. Then he's aware of it, and then he's still doubting it. So it's a funny game that we play with each other. It's a relationship that we have, that everybody else has with their mothers. So I'm thankful for anybody who's listening to me right now. And if there's any questions, I can take them. Or I have a lot of blessings I could do, which means a lot of singing and a lot of funny noises and funny sounds and funny clickings, and everything that makes a sound is making a feeling. Every sound is a feeling, a memory, a creation. The more you listen, the more you hear.
Yes, thank you so much for joining us today. We do have people asking for beautiful blessings from you.
Thank you. Meu warari aso yo no aki ana sayawi ai no ha si awana iawana hai ko na iana soyai kayawana Yawasi Naya Wahayena Wasayawan Yawa Hianoasi Hayawanai Shayawanahi Anoa saya he ano I ano hai 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 saya na wahi Sakia, oh, Anaya wasakia. Ianawa, he a sayawaka, yawaha. Iasanayawaki, anawaha, he a sayawaka, anawa sushuwaki. Nahi, yawasaki, anawaha, yanawasaha. Show anaya waki. No asasha waki anawahasi hanawaki. No asashi waki alawana iyawa. Show no asika naya hiyawa. Show yawi anawaha. Sayaka yawanai, naya sahaya wana, samu yawasaki yashaya yawanai, naya wasiar wana kasa yawi, nayo yawakali yanaya shushuko yuno yati yakasa waya yanaya wiyawasiar wanai, shoyalaka yawana sikara yahoo.
Shayahinawe. Nahu Sayawaki. Nayawaha si Shiawanaya. Noyawa si Shiawanawe. Noha Sakaya hiyawana. Sukiya taha shuko. Shukoha yana. Nawasaki wa. Noyawa si Shiawara hiyanawa kiyasa. Wow. Nawasuku shushua raraya nawaka sataha shakata yawanaya yawakia sanaya wakasushua shianaya kasati yawanaha yashuaki yanaya haya yawanasa shoya wiyawana suku tushahia kiyawa roya wiyawasia rahia wanaya kasati yawasia ruana kiyanaya shushua rakiyanaya tata yawasia ruana shiakaya hi No sawaya kia wana wahia sakua niya taya hiya wasi ara wana hiya we. Soko toya shaya kuwara hiya wana sika taya hawa ara hiya wana we. No yo wasa kia ta. Shoyo wea wana wa. Naha hiya wea sa. Shoko taya hiya na. Miha shuku sha iku la i na wasu kutaha hiya na wasika ara. No yawasi akana ya iya wa shuwa na iya sakaya wa ni iya wa saki. If anybody else feels like they want to say something right now, there's always time. Do a blessing.
Oh, this is beautiful. I love this. I wanted to ask, you said you are, well, if you're still around, JD's soul mother?
Yes.
Are you able to elaborate on that at all for us to know a little bit more about you?
I can talk about your JD's experience of me in this lifetime. And it has been a wonderful experience for him, for me, and for everyone else who is feeling their own mother right now. And that I'm always here, I'm always around, I'm always watching. I feel what you feel.
So you are like a guide, like the mother energy, the guide for JD?
Yes, not only JD, but it can seem like that. And that's,
are you in spirit?
Yes, I'm in spirit. I have had lifetimes on Earth.
Is there a interesting lifetime you've had on Earth that you would like to go into detail about?
No, but I love the nature. I love to connect to my soul mother also, Gaia, everyone's mother, which is me, which is the soul part of the mother soul of all souls, the female. So I would say that my experience on Earth is to connect to the mother part of the experience of having a human form on this planet. And it's very individual and a very special experience. And I would like to hear more about your experience, though, how your experience really is and what you're experiencing. And therefore, when you're hearing yourself speaking, I can hear you at the same time. I'm always connected.
What do you mean by that? When I'm speaking, you can hear me at the same time.
Everything is now. And everything you hear now, I hear also. So when you create, like I do now, you hear me at the same time I hear myself.
All right. That makes sense a little bit now that you explained it. So we are having some questions come in for you. Michelle Euro is asking if there's any relation with you and her, because she said Johannesson, her and Harrison are deeply connected.
Sorry, I don't hear you. I have to come closer. You have to speak up.
Oh, yes. Michelle Euro was asking if there's a connection with you and her.
Yes. Yes. I don't elaborate on how, but I will say yes, we are definitely connected.
Okay, interesting. Does that connection have anything to do with Harrison as well? She said Johannes, her, and Harrison are very connected.
Yes, we are all very, very connected, all in this realm at this time, on so many levels, that is so strong, that we all feel that it's amazing. So it is true what you feel.
Okay.
So thank you for asking.
Thank you. Is there a name that we could get for you?
For me?
Yes.
A name for me?
Yes.
What my name is?
Uh-huh.
My name is Miia.
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 Oh, thank you, Miia.
Thank
beautiful.
You. I'm very, very honored. You have created me.
Wow.
This creation. So I am on it.
Thank you. I wanted to ask if there are any pieces of wisdom, of knowledge that you would like to share with the human collective as a whole regarding these current energies and everything we are going through.
Everything already happened. We are already where we're supposed to be. Everything is already all right. And so it will for always be. So connect to yourself. As much as you can, all the time. And mantras are helpful. They are helping Johannes very much. And that's the way he can connect to me also even more.
Okay, thank you so much, Miia. We have a question from Pete for you. If you are able to unmute Pete.
Hi.
Hello.
I have a question. I sense that I know you from somewhere.
Mm-hmm. And what do you know me from?
Through the energies from during the point from the singing. It just somehow it unlocked my chakras of remembering something.
I didn't hear everything what you hear, what you said. I'm sorry, can you speak up?
I remember somewhere in my past that I met you somewhere.
Oh, yes.
That I sense within my chakras.
Yes. That's very true.
I was just saying, where have I met you somewhere? Because you seem very familiar. Even the name sounds very familiar.
I am the mother of this creation. The mother soul of this creation. Names and definitions makes me small or makes yourself small. I don't actually want to call myself anything or anyone. I like my name, Miia, for sure.
I too understand that.
But for your understanding, and still I don't want to actually give yourself that understanding, but call it an archangel, call it divine creation of mother, soul, of all. I'm here always. And I'm within you everywhere. I'm everywhere.
Oh, okay. Well, my other question is that what is happening in my body at this moment? One moment, I was at a high frequency state. The next moment, during when the disturbance came in, my body seemed to cause accidents within my physical situation in life.
Do you trust yourselves?
I do 100%.
Then you trust me, and whatever I will say to you is going to be my truth to why you feel the way you feel. But I would say there's a lot of past that still needs to be let go of. What you believe in. But there are symbols, healing symbols that you can use yourself of to cleanse yourself from any unbalance. And Johannes can share them with you later, personally.
Okay.
And they will help you and everyone else in your world.
Okay, thank you so much. And my last question for today is that what is my wife saying to me at this moment?
What your wife is saying to you?
Yes, due to the imbalance of my energies.
There is a lot of past with your wife. And there is love within you to still find out that will unfold, so to speak, that are just around the corner for you. So be patient and be aware of what's going on without feeling any kind of pressure. And to surrender. I don't know what your wife is saying to you right now, but if I would be your wife, I would just tell you what I feel about you, what you mean to me. And I would embrace what it is that I love about you. So maybe that's what she's saying right now. She's embracing the love for you right now. Because you maybe need to feel it. And then she's there to give it to you when you want it. And it's very pleasant to be here and to be able to do that, to experience each other on this level where we can physically touch each other and hug each other. So she's telling that she wants more hugs from you. She wants to hug you more.
I can feel her energy just giving me a warm embrace. And because of that, it brings tears in my eyes at this moment.
Yeah, it's true. And hugs right now, and you can feel it, and And it is beautiful. It is so beautiful that we can be able to do this. You're creating this to be possible for us. You're creating this moment right now. We are incredible beings, creation, creators.
How the last moment of my question before it goes, how can I realign my chakras with my wife's help and help achieve a higher mental psychic state and connecting to the mid-fifth dimension?
Johannes has some finished practices for you personally. So just contact him and he will go through it with you. It's very easy, simple exercises that will help you and your wife.
Okay, thank you so much.
You chose to do this together also, so it's wonderful that you know that.
Much love.
Thank you.
Much love to you and to my wife as well.
Thank you. We did have one last question before we move forward. Miia, there was a question on the YouTube live chat. A user, Shanman No Legal, unless that's no legal, I think it looks like one word. Shanman asks, first said they've had experience with the Golden Triangle Head beings, which is interesting. They ask, what is my connection to Archangel Lucifer? Thank you.
Creation itself makes you connected to this being. Within creation, everything is connected. Nothing is actually separate from source, ever. So there is a memory of a lifetime of this being in memory of creation in this form, human creation. And I can't tell you anything more specific than what you're feeling yourself about that being. And the strongest connection you can ever have is with yourself. I am here for you, but it depends on how much you actually listen also to me, because I am you, and it depends on how much you actually trust yourself. But I assure you that you have all the answers already now to that question, if you wish to desire an answer.
Thank you so much, Miia. We're getting close to moving forward. I really appreciate you coming through today and sharing with us. And I guess the last thing I would like to request is for another quick, beautiful song from your heart.
For me?
Yes. Johannes or anyone who would like to assist.
Of course, of course. Yuna sakataya naki wayano sayakataya natsi hayawa nayaka sato jayawaniya su nayaka sayawaniya su shakatana sakashushu nayakatu yasakana yuakariyawanu Saya yawa nakasi arawe anaya naya kataya wana hiya wani yawa shoyo yo 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 nalaya hiya no sa hiya wana ya hana we ana soya ne ya wa he asa ya na we ha hiya wa Naya wasi shana wae anna jaya yawe anna yawae na si wana yawa waha yawe na hayawi Shuhana yae awa si anna we yahoa ne awa sahi awa nihana se wae ya na haya we sayana uha sayana ye wana ye wana ye awa sahi awa ni Wahaya ni, wahaya ni, asaya hea we, nahaya we, anasaya we, saya we, anawaya we, haya sana we, anaya, wahawi, anaya, wahawi, anaya, wahawi.
Namaste.
That was so beautiful. Thank you so much, JD, for joining us today and channeling for us. It was such a pleasure having you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, antes yo toto ko shendia haya ta ote hiki asanta hayo roto onta haya ta aka. Namaste. And moving forward, we now have Justin Arnott, who is going to channel for us. And again, please check out our YouTube channel that Justin and I have started together, Unity X Change, where we are posting his channelings he's bringing through. There's already been a nutrition guide from Yeshua, which is pretty cool. Modalities in existence from the Akashic Records. It's quite an endeavor and we're very excited. So welcome, Justin. Thank you for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me. Glad I can help out.
Yeah. Is your camera working?
Yep. I can see myself. Can
everybody else? Okay. Well, it might be a glitch on my part. That happens sometimes. So I hope other people are able to see Justin.
I heard your audio cut out for a short amount of time.
Oh boy. Well, you know.
Okay. No, they said they can see me. So.
Okay, great. Well then, please.
I didn't really have a plan when this day started. I kind of had an idea of a couple different beings that wanted to come through. I was just going to let them choose who wanted the channel more. So I felt Vishnu. earlier. I don't know if that energy is still around. Something powerful is here, though, so it should be interesting. All right, I'll open up and let it start. Much love to you all. Greetings. This is High Protector Vishnu. I am currently seated as a high level or high angel, 13th dimensional energy. I preside over the beings of Pleiade, and I assist with the transfer of energy from your realm back to Source. Today I bring messages of asking you questions. As the celestial solstice comes to an end, I ask you, what have you done with this energy? Have you become stronger? Have you found knowledge? Have you made questions? Have you answered questions? What have you done with this beautiful energy? Are you lost, or have you been found? So many people ask the heavens, I want this, I want to do this, I want to be this, and yet they are not. Because it is them who wants. Understand that fourth dimension, fifth dimension, sixth, seventh, eighth, 20. These dimensions are for beings of service. We help everybody. Being a spiritual warrior is not about helping yourself. It's about helping as many people as possible. If you're not using your energy to help others, what are you doing? Stop saying I, and start asking, how can I help you? How do you need help? Look to help as many as possible. Don't discriminate between color and language. Learn telepathy. You already know it. Train this muscle. Stop doubting yourself. stop doubting others. There's no reason to spread negativity. If your purpose is to show negativity, find another purpose for you not helping the ascension. If you drowned in negativity and it's all you want to share, stop sharing until you can cleanse yourself. Be positive. Be a strong warrior of the light. So I ask again, what have you done with the beautiful energy of the celestial solstice? Are you now a stronger telepath? Have you found stronger healing? Has your toning reached new levels? Are you capable of reading the Akashic records? Your conditioning with the masculinity, the masculine energy, overbears much of your femininity. Find unison between the two. Find the connection to your realm, to your Gaia. For without this connection, you will not find higher energy. When you find the higher energy, you will become tired. Perhaps momentarily uplifted. Maybe even for several hours, you'll feel giant energy rushes, but then become soon tired. Give it much practice. The higher energy is difficult to get used to, even though it is softer. It packs more punch. Take your time. Practice often throughout the day. Even though the celestial solstice is coming to an end, there is still wonderful energy to be collected. Beautiful fourth and fifth dimension energy, which you can use to help the entire collective reach new heights. There is much negativity on your realm. Only through sharing with each other, sharing with Gaia, will you find the path. Stop serving yourself and serve others. So when you tell yourself, you sit down and you say, I want to be a telepath. You need to ask yourself, why do you want to be a telepath? I want to be a bilocator. Why do you want to be a bilocator? Are you going to use these gifts to help other people? Should you be able to connect to the higher frequencies, what would you do with it? Would you wallow in your ego? Look what I can do. I can talk to these people. Or would you allow their message to come through and be humble as the conduit? I want to bilocate. What would you do with this? Would you use this to heal others in need? Or would you be selfish and sit on beautiful beaches and use your energy for your own purpose? There is much work to be done. There are many in need of help. Take your time. Choose wisely. For those who do choose wisely will be uplifted and will be shown the path. Those who choose to wallow in ego will stay in their ego and will stay in their negativity. So wallow all you want. For the high energy is for those who are going to do the most good. And when you're ready to move past your negativity, you let your ego go. You forgive all of those who have harmed you. It will be time for you to join your higher frequency kin. There are many, many practices available to you. Many subtle exercises, breathing exercises, in which you can find deep meditation and connection. Use your energy wisely. So many people, so many wise and benevolent beings suggest that you turn inward. I would suggest that you reach out. I believe there's been much confusion with looking inward, for they mean you need to balance the masculine and feminine and connect to your realm so that you can share your energy. However, I believe that it's best described as reaching out to help others. Stop focusing on yourself. Other than if you need healing or if you have issues you need to overcome before you can help others, by all means, take time, take energy, call upon your higher brethren for help. It's what we're here to do. There's nothing more that would bring us joy than to help elevate you, should you be ready to do so. Find forgiveness. Find compassion. Become a blessed soul warrior, a mighty warrior of the light, and smite the darkness where it sits. And they say that it glooms, that it waits. The darkness is active. The negativity is active. It does not sit around. It moves. It searches. It tries to hide the light. The light will push it back. Although we are few, we are much stronger. Be positive. Allow positive messages to reach as many as possible. Help as many as possible. Use your energy for the greater good. There is still, by your calendar, another 35 days of fifth dimensional energy passively floating by your realm. Are you going to sit in naivety and allow it to pass by? Or are you going to make the effort to absorb as much of it as possible so that you can help the greater good? When the fifth dimension energy is gone, Gaia will have absorbed much of it, and she will be radiating much of this energy, along with much fourth dimension energy. And when the heart of this passive cloud flows past, you will still have months of fourth dimension energy. Take your time. Use your energy efficiently. Learn how to cultivate energy. Learn how to change your energy network to benefit the good of all, not the good of you. Once the energy cloud has passed, Gaia will have done much self-healing, and there are many healers who work diligently to help her along this path. Help your realm. If you have nothing to do, you sit bored. Turn your palms to Gaia and share your energy with her. And then ask her to receive the energy. Ask her to help you reach new levels so that you can help her more, so that you can help all creation, not just humanity. You're not the only race. You're not the only culture. There are many who require help. You are capable of doing this. Do not sit idle. Release the mind control. Use your energy efficiently and become the lesser creator you were meant to be. There are already many who walk this path. Who doubt themselves. Remove all doubt and negativity and bask in the light of Source. Channel this beautiful energy and help everyone. My message is brief but powerful. Yena kosha nayar nayor ni itchenukus yena ish. Tosa nakara no kono yor. There are many benevolent beings who wish to help you. Allow their work to shine through you. Become the light of source. Yanakayana usenat utahara nayakis. Naath noko alashan yana usana or nayakita isina osh. Much love to you all.
Thank you, Vishnu. Welcome back, Justin. Take your time. That was a very powerful message. Thank you.
Welcome. Wow.
Lots of love.
Yeah. It's got some power. Holy. It's my first time channeling Vishnu out loud. It's
yeah.
Intense. Holy.
Yeah, it is. That was really incredible, especially that Vishnu brought up the celestial solstice and the fourth dimensional, fifth dimensional energies, and how the 45D energies are lasting for the cloud that we're going through is lasting for another 35 days. And the celestial solstice, I believe, ends on February 9th. I think it is, if I'm correct about that. So there's a lot of really fascinating energy that's been coming in for all of us, and we're able to utilize it for our highest greatest good, especially by setting the intention for it to positively impact us. So that was really interesting. And we did have, you know, some people were, you know, wanting to ask questions, but I guess today, from Vishnu, it was strictly a message, which is definitely understandable. So we really appreciate you channeling Vishnu out loud for the first time. So thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. He's been speaking to me for a little bit, although I feel both energies, not just one. Although most angels have both of them, and they're just exactly what we need, right?
Right.
You can see them as male or female. They're whatever energy you require. So.
Yeah, exactly. Because a lot of people, they get caught up on, oh, well, I know Vishnu is female. I know Vishnu is male.
Yeah.
Technically, in the grand scheme of things, it's all the same.
It doesn't matter what bits and pieces you have. You have masculine and feminine energy. So you should try to be the perfect combination of both, despite whatever bits and pieces you were given.
That's right. It's about integrating the wholeness of all that is. So we're very blessed to be able to go through these experiences and learn these things. And I mean, we do have a few questions left. I did want to give you as much time as I was able to give the other channelers. And one of the questions you might be able to answer right now, just based off of your own personal experiences, is Angie was asking, how do you perceive the fourth and fifth density?
How do I perceive it? Confidence. There's a confidence about it that many people don't possess. When you start harnessing the energy and you start realizing I can do incredible things to help many, many people, it brings confidence. And the more people you help, the easier it gets to release the doubt. But even before you start helping other people, that just gotta let it go and help as many people as possible.
Yeah, she said you basically stand in your full power, right?
Yeah, you know, it. You don't let anything stand in your way. You know, you see somebody in need, it's just that person needs my help and I can help them. I know I can. Happen. And that's what it's like. I see this.
It's so amazing.
I see this hurt. I see this pain. I can make that go away. And you make it happen. And that's what it's like.
Yes. We all are healers, all of us. We have the capability to heal, every single one of us. It's based off of a belief system and understanding. And so that is one of the things you're doing, Justin, with Unity Shamanism. Are you able to go over that very briefly in terms of your experiences having the privilege to go through the Akashic Records, some of the Akashic Records, the healing portions of it in particular, and being able to study the base 500 healing modalities and kind of like what insight it has brought you to, because that alone must be an absolutely astronomical experience.
I've been blessed to have many, many teachers. And although it's been a very long and long, long path, it's brought a lot of insight. And meeting with so many wonderful, wonderful people, beings, I've learned that no matter where the energy comes from, whether it's Lyran or Pleiady or Orion Council, Arcturian, wherever, it's all from the exact same source. And it's just a different interpretation of the Akashic Records and how that culture uses their interpretation to manifest healing energy or whatever it is they're trying to do. So no matter how you look at it, whatever energy somebody requires, it all comes from the same source. It's all just about how you present it to that person's energy. And it's really led me to understand how diverse humanity is, because not everybody will accept angelic healing. Not everybody will accept Pleiadian healing. Not everyone will accept Arcturian healing. While that modality could probably fix, you know, 90% of the issues, whichever modality it is, the person needs to accept what is happening and release. Some people talk about having to go through their own suffering to find their own light. It's because they choose to do this. You don't have to suffer. You know, reach out to your friends and just let go of the negativity. There's no reason to hold on to pain. If you're holding on to pain, it's because you're not willing to let it go. Especially if you're dealing with a quality healer. At some point, you just got to be like, it's time for me to heal. It's time for me to help others. And do it. Every way that you can. Toning, channeling, telepathy, bilocation, healing. So many different forms of music, artwork. Just become the best you that you can be and stop walking through the negativity, you know, just let it go. There's no
We have a few questions about what you're saying right now in particular. Jonah Lee was asking, I wonder how we are to serve another when it's not obvious how to help them, and if they're unaware of it, or unable to tell, how can we help them? And then Christine kind of asked a similar question, you know, for sending healing.
You know, intention is everything. Even if you can sense that something is off with somebody, just share your heart energy with them. You know, most of us are empaths, so our intuition is pretty on point. You know, when you see somebody hurting, or you can feel that they're hurting, you don't have to go up to them and freak them out. Oh, I'm a light worker. You can stand back and just share your love, you know, focus your breath and share your heart energy with that person. You might even see them start looking around like, what? I feel better. Where is this coming from? You know, and you don't have to run up there and, oh, look what I did. You know what you did. Be happy with it. You can see it change them. Help them out from a distance. You don't have to physically interact with them in order to help them. You know, there's many, many different ways of sharing energy, you know, and you don't have to be egoic about it. You know, you can do it from a distance.
Yes. And it also seems like doing it without any expectation of the result is really the key. Christine was asking, you know, I'm sending healing to a friend who's in pain, but the friend isn't getting better. So is that me? Am I interfering with his path? Or okay,
well, if you're sharing healing with a friend and it's not working, it's probably because there's deeper issues there. Reiki is a very powerful tool, but if they have powerful emotions inside them that have set seed and are growing roots, the Reiki is going to go to that first, because it's intelligent and it sees emotional trauma as more important than physical. So it's going to help the emotional trauma before it helps the physical. Reiki practitioners see it all the time. Somebody comes in, oh, my elbow, it hurts so bad. But they have a broken heart, or they have, you know, issues in their root that need to be healed before they can physically heal. So then this Reiki practitioner practices on them for 2 hours and can feel it just absorbing to their heart. And the person leaves there thinking, oh man, that person had no idea what they're doing. It's 2 hours they've been working on me and I still can't use my arm. What's going on? Well, it's because you have emotional trauma that needs to be healed before the physical will come through. Now, Reiki can heal this, but it takes time to allow that to happen. There are different understandings that can remove this pain relatively quick, but it can cause discomfort, to say the least. And while Reiki itself is always passive and it's always beautiful and it's always gentle, not all healing modalities are gentle, but they can be extremely effective. And sometimes people need that in order to understand there is something incredible with healing. You just have to co-create it, you know, and allow it to happen. That's another huge part, you know, that her friend might be saying, yes, I want this healing, please help me out, and not willing to heal because they're not willing to let go of this emotional trauma. So if they're holding a grudge, you know, they're gonna have to find forgiveness in order to carry on, you know. And that's another huge part, you know, if somebody's holding on to negativity, can't help them. You can, of course, share as much energy as you're willing to share, you know, and always call on your friends because they will send you energy to pass on to them. And it helps so much. It really, really does. So, you know, be as positive as possible and be upbeat as possible. And if your Reiki isn't working, don't doubt yourself. You might need a little bit more understanding, so that you can be a little bit more effective healer. But definitely don't doubt your Reiki, because it's incredible. Magic happens with Reiki.
Yes,
miracles happen with Reiki.
It's co-creation.
Yeah, exactly. Plus co-creation. Right?
No. Michelle had a question.
I hope I answered your question.
Yeah, I think so.
What did Michelle?
Yeah, that is a very thorough, and it was right along the same ideas of what I was thinking about. However, I was wondering, you know, sometimes I experienced this over the last couple of months. I've been sending healing for the better part of a year on a pretty regular basis, and asking a lot of people in our communities to do that with me, you know, as many people as are willing. And the sickness just keeps coming back. I don't know if this is a contract. I definitely know the belief system is not super strong. It's like, yeah, I get it, but I don't want to look at it. And I actually felt like maybe I'm just not the right person to be spending time and energy sending this healing, because I felt defeated, because it doesn't matter how many times I explain how, you know, dis-ease happens, it doesn't change the behavior. And then there's to some degree the idea of guilt associated with not being willing. So I don't know what the answer to that is. Like, even if it's apparent that they're not really willing to receive this help, do you do it anyway? Do you like makes, you know what I mean?
You can only do so much. Sometimes you got to cut it loose. I genuinely believe, though, that if someone wants to heal, they're going to heal.
I believe that also, but so, you know, sometimes you think you want a thing, but you're not willing to do the things to make it happen. Right?
Yeah. So if you're working on somebody, and it's been a long amount of time, like a year, it might not be you. You might just need a different modality, although your toning does incredible things for people.
It's not really that. It's like he'd get better, and then the thought process would come back, the really diabolical thought process that like incapacitates him emotionally and mentally. Yeah. And then he'd get sick again, and it just gets worse. So he gets better, worse, better, worse, better, worse, so better,
him,
worse.
That's him not willing to heal.
Right.
You know, in the moment he says, yes, I want to heal. And then the next day he's just drowning in negativity again, and he's not releasing it, you know?
Correct.
It could be, you know, maybe it's something locked in one of his chakras. Maybe he's got some guilt from a previous life, or maybe.
What if it's just karma? Or what if he decided this is his contract? Or like, I don't really understand.
Well, you know, that very well could be as well. Because some people are put here to lower the frequency. But, you know, if he's saying, I want to heal, chances are he wants to heal. He just doesn't know how to go about doing it. And, you know, that maybe he's got to have maybe he's got something blocking in some of his chakras, you know, past life memory, or.
I'm just going to pass him over to you.
Yeah. I'll be willing to help anybody. You know, if anybody knows anyone that is ailing from anything, I want to try to heal everything. I've been having really cool success with a wide variety of things. Please, if you know anybody where normal medicine isn't working, please have them contact me. I'd be glad to help anybody. And I'm super excited to try a bunch of different things, because I'm starting to get a really, really decent understanding about how healing works and about how friends can help everybody. So please, if you know anybody that's not feeling properly and wants to heal, please reach out to me, and I'll definitely do my best to help.
All right. Thanks, Justin.
You're welcome, Michelle.
Michelle,
thank you, Michelle.
It's really been an exciting ride. Justin, you've helped already heal arthritis, bladder stones, ovarian cysts, leaky heart valves. Gosh, the list just goes on. Headaches.
Yeah, headaches.
Insomnia.
Hearing disorders.
Popping knees.
Yeah.
Constantly popping knees.
Yeah. Still pretty fresh. The one of the healings that I did, but I helped heal an STI. Haven't done a follow up yet, but I'm pretty sure it worked. So that it ranges far.
And it depends on the person, what the person needs. Like you said, it depends on the energy that they need, and this is. The healing is being channeled through. It's absolutely amazing, and we all have the ability to do this. We all have the ability to connect and to assist with healing coming through. So.
Yes, Michelle. one of the ones that wouldn't go away.
Yeah. Yeah. She asked if it was actually an STD that got healed. So that happened.
Yeah, well, disease or infection, however you want to call it, you know.
But, right, where people are coming with all sorts of different things, and sometimes, and the biggest ones are actually emotional seeds.
Yeah.
When emotional seeds sit in people and actually turn into plants. And so we're going to be going over information about this on our channel, Unity Exchange. You can reach out to Justin, unityshamanism@gmail.com. We do have to probably close up for today, but I wanted to thank everybody. I know Adey already had to leave. She had to go to work. Thank you, JD. Oh, boy, he just left. I missed him. But we really appreciate everybody joining today for an amazing channel panel yet again. And thank you, everybody, for watching. So the description, the links for everything will be in the description on the video. And please don't hesitate to reach out. We so much appreciate your support and the energy. And so many blessings to everyone. Namaste. We love you and thank you.
Namaste.